we are all grateful to our parents, because today we have grown very big in life. Today we have about 26 institutions, about 22,000 students. It's all consequence of my mother's and father's decision to come and settle here. If they would not have come and settled here, obviously none of the things you see now here or at Mangalore or at Bangalore would not have happened. Definitely it would not have happened.
This is the story of Mother Meenakshi Hegde and her six children and her grandchildren and great-grandchildren. Being the children of highly reputed and nationally popular Justice K. Hegde, their mother brought them up to the match with the same stature of their father, giving more importance to values and cordial behavior at home and elsewhere. The children have seen the world through the eyes of their mother. Their dreams were also set accordingly. All of them excelled in their chosen spectrum of life and career. Justice K. Hegde was also very much influenced by this lady of large heart and broad smile. She was an embodiment of love. She always welcomed people at home and took care of them with compassion. Her hospitality had reflected in making her home a welcome home, and many people of various stature and positions in society fondly remembers her for her hospitality and compassionate care. Nitte Meenakshi Hegde had influenced the vision of Justice K. Hegde very much. After being in public life for nearly 50 years with all the comforts and stature of a judge and speaker, the decision of the couple to move back to Nitte village and settle down in the ambience of silence and sentiments made a huge difference. Nitte Education Trust and every initiative in education and social upliftment thereafter were started on their coming back to Nitte village. Sri N. Vinaya Hegde attributes major portion of the credit of his upbringing to the devotion of his mother. The personality that he has achieved is an outcome of selfless contribution of his mother.
I rate my mother very high, because if there is few good things in me, if others see, I dedicate it fully to my mother. Because I told you also in the morning, my father had hardly any time for us. He was a very busy lawyer, was a very busy politician, very successful person. So obviously until we grew, until we became 30, 35, we never had an affectionate moment with him. It's all the affection for us, as I grew, it was from the mother's side. So that's why I always feel some of us, if we have any good thing left in us, I dedicate it to my mother, because it's a blessing. But we have grown under the shadow of our father. That's a separate issue. Our economic success, maybe our growth in other areas are due to my father. But personality growth, I obviously dedicate it to my mother.
Mother Meenakshi Hegde was an embodiment of love. She considered humanity as one family. Everyone was treated equal and special attention was given for the children. Many children got shelter under the loving and compassionate care of Mother Meenakshi Hegde. She was an inspiration and motivation for many people to come up in life. She taught her children the lessons of self-respect, importance of gaining dignity, to have concern for others.
My mother used to cook, so so much and entertain them. Not only that, my father's side also, my mother was very good to her in-law. All the my father's nephews and all stayed with us and studied. And my mother, with two small servants, she managed and took care of them. And they're still very fond of our family.
Mother holds the key of a respected family. She always cares and nurtures. Mother tells stories and instill dreams in children. Togetherness with people and oneness with nature was her personality. Children are brought up being socially responsible, successful and respectable. Helping people was a passion for her. She could come out of a trauma within no time. Forgetting difficulties, she always shown happiness to be with more people, never complained about difficulties of any kind. Prayerful, very often, she always kept God at prime positions.
She was a great woman. She appreciated whatever good things we children did. At the same time, she was strict when it came to values. She was a great hostess. I think she was a great cook too, because many of my relatives used to praise her food, and she was very generous too, not only to the children but also to the servant boys at home. We hardly heard any conflict between my father and my mother, so we grew up in an atmosphere of peace.
She was world educated than school educated. She was willing to learn and upgrade herself. She learned Hindi and English languages with good communication skills and a bit of Tamil too. Many of the good habits that the children had learned are all inherited from their mother.
Why I place them so high? This entire institution, the Education Trust or whatever it is, would never have come, not for my parents coming and settling in this village. We have no connection with this village. Can you believe that I have hardly come to this village more than 4 or 5 times before my father decided to settle here? My first role was to build this house here. I had a little role in the physically supervising the house construction, and we had a small plantation. There also had a small road. So that was my beginning of my visit here. And their coming here obviously made a huge change in my life.
I remember she took some partial attitude towards me. Whenever I wanted some clothes, she gathered enough money from her savings to buy me that. I still remember the day when she bought me a pair of canvas shoes out of the newspaper sold. I can't forget those days.
She used to get up early in the morning. She did most of her works on her own. She preferred to do things by hand and was very active in all activities in the family. Really enjoyed every work that she did and never remained tired. This habit made the children work more than office hours and usual schedules. Always welcomed people with a charming smile.
When I was about 3 years old, then we came to Mangalore, and we were 6 children. And we had always at least 2 of my cousins living in the house. So we were 8 of us living in the house at a time. And I remember my mother working very hard with very 1 or 2 servants. But all of us had fun with her. house was a very happy one, I would say. Even though we saw very little about our father during our younger days because of his busy schedule. At times we didn't see him at all the whole day because he went to office before we got up and he came back from his office after we went to sleep. But my mother looked after all of us, and the most important thing is she didn't make any difference between not only her children but also her nephews and nieces.
Mother Meenakshi Hegde was born in the historic village Mundkur in the year 1914, 5 years younger to Justice K.S. Hegde. Her father, Naliguttu Siddhu Shetty, was a landlord who was helpful to the entire village. He was a social reformer who worked for society beyond caste and class barriers. Naliguttu Siddhu Shetty contributed the Tirtha Mantapa for the ancient Sri Durga Parameshwari Temple, Mundkur, in 1909. Incidentally, this is the year Justice K.S. Hegde was born. Naliguttu Siddhu Shetty was a great support for the people and was a shelter for many at distress. He was highly humane and loved ordinary life away from positions and luxury. Meenakshi was just less than 4 years when she lost her loving father. Tulu Nadu was guided by the matrilineal system at that time. She came back to her mother's home with the kids and was lovingly received back at home. The wounded heart of Meenakshi got another shock when she was 8 years. She lost her mother. The pain of a child losing a very loving father and mother within an age 8 years is beyond description and explanation. This must have changed her personality into yogic detachment towards everyone and everything. She loved everyone equally.
And she was brought up by her maternal aunt. And that's the strength of a joint family. Though they had no father and mother, her two brothers were helped to finish their MBBS course from reputed medical colleges from Chennai. Mother was married to a very well-known lawyer. The elder sister was married to a doctor who became very popular in Mulki, Bantwal area. So I think all that happened largely because of the support of the family. And my mother has completely repaid it because after she made the house, she has looked after a lot of children from this place to continue their education in Mangalore. Those days, Mangalore did not have too many hostels except the Buns Hostel. To an extent, St. Aloysius College Hostel was there. But many of her nephews and nieces studied from their houses. So she helped a lot of these children to finish their education from our house. So they have done well. Most of them have done well in life. Her sister's two children, boys, retired as general manager of Greaves Cotton, Dr. N.R. Shetty, who is also one of the important factors on the development of Nitte Education Trust, ended up as the vice chancellor of Bangalore University. So I think as a family, we have grown to a very high level because of the strong family background. If you believe in genetics, maybe genetics, maybe the hand-holding, maybe family and relative support. Most of us have done excellently well in life.
Life started to come back to normal, and the loving care of her aunts and uncles made it faster. Presence of her brothers and sisters had increased her confidence level. Nitte village was calm and serene. People were all around and everyone was like family member. Meenakshi looked at nature as an extended family. Plants and flowers impressed her. Birds and animals attracted her. Trees and sky instilled curiosity in her. She grew up experiencing the wonders of natural world. Every living system in the world are active all the time. Meenakshi took the spirit of living lively. Whatever happened gave her a reason, and she started to derive the extended purpose of everything in life. Slowly, she had turned to be a universal person. Her marriage to Kaudur Sadananda Hegde, fondly known as K.S. Hegde, was an all the more happy event for Meenakshi, since she could continue being at her own home.
There's hardly any argument. Even though there were times when my father lost his temper and raised his voice, but my mother, I don't recall her talking back to me. She was always in touch with all our neighbors in Sadashiro Road, and till the end she either used to meet them or their children, and she used to talk about the younger days in our Mangalore house.
This is one rare case. My father made a huge sacrifice for coming and settling down in his wife's place. That's a great sacrifice he did. And maybe my mother motivated him to do that. So we are one very happy family, because it's the affection of our parents which keep us together.
Her attachment to the village was stronger than every other thing by that time. Everything went normal, even when the learned lawyer entered the mainstream of her life. Her husband was college educated and she was world educated. K.S. Hegde was highly impressed with her wisdom and swiftness in action. His domain knowledge and her soft skills became a winning combination of higher respect. He was an efficient society builder and she was a wonderful homemaker. The combination of knowledge and wisdom earned them widespread respect. Justice K.S. Hegde had experienced and acknowledged it many times.
One thing I clearly remember, I used to come home every other year and my dad would be sitting outside waiting for the car to come. That was kind of emotional for me. And my mom would be in the kitchen fixing food for all of us. They're a very compatible couple. Yeah.
She was a very good daughter-in-law, took care of my parents.
Yeah, we had the privilege of looking after them till their end.
Food is a most important part in this family. Everybody likes good food.
Actually, they practiced what they preached, and I should say it's almost ingrained in most of us.
While Justice K.S. Hegde gained reputation as judge and speaker, Mother Meenakshi Hegde earned reputation as a wonderful host. Many great people across the world acclaimed her hospitality. Nitte House anywhere in India remained an open house for the people from the village. Many made up their life under the hospitality and care of Mother Meenakshi Hegde. The family tradition continues today with the spirit instilled from the ancestors.
Actually, we used to
staying in Bahrain for 21 years, and we thought after retirement we'll come here, which my mother had given that place to me, and spend some time with my parents. Unfortunately, before we came back, she died. So I'm very, very grateful to my brother for buying that house from me, because it has been, he's been taking so much care, and we get a chance to spend and remember the olden days we used to be together.
But again, that house also, they maintained it well. I took it from my sister, and it has been maintained well. It doesn't look like a house where people don't live. The people who look after the house, they have a commitment. They have a commitment for my parents, and the house is in a more than good condition, absolutely more than good condition for a rural house. That house and this place is a very special place for us. It's a very, very special place. And today this also has become a special place for the students also, because there are a lot of activities to happen here. Down there there's a museum which we have preserved old photographs of my father. There's a small seminar hall there. And below that there's a small open area where they conduct musical dance programs for the students. Large number of boys and girls, about 2,500-3,000 students live in the campus.
And I'm really grateful to my brother for building this also. Any happy occasion, first thing we do is come here and take their blessing, and my sister, and it really becomes a little emotional when we come here.
Mother Meenakshi Hegde had visited large number of places in the world. At every visit, her attachment to the Nitte village multiplied. The love and affection bestowed at Nitte village was more heartwarming than the formal and official life at everywhere else. At Nitte, people meant what they spoke. It could be the dream of Mother Meenakshi Hegde that made Justice K. Hegde to come back to Nitte village. They wanted to be very happy, to be active after their retired life. Children were all settled by the time into various positions of reputation and recognition. They were contented and happy. The welfare programs resulted in the advent of a school in Nitte. Thus, the village got the first school, and the school education that Mother Meenakshi Hegde was deprived of was made available for all, particularly girl children. It was the beginning of a long journey. She loved the innocence of childhood and village life. People were her passion always. Coming back to Nitte village was the most important decision that she had taken in her life. She never had fallen in the trap of luxury. She lived simple all through her life.
I'm grateful to God for giving me an opportunity of being a part of this family. And I'm grateful to my parents for whatever values they have taught us. And it's because of their values we have some respect in the society.
She inspired them a lot. She instilled dreams even in the minds of passers-by. Everyone loved her like own mother.